Hey everybody, so in this video, in addition to Wireshark and looking at packets, we're going to take a look at NMAP and how some of those scans work at the packet level. Now, I know if you, like me, if you're studying for any certifications, right now I'm going for a couple of cybersecurity certifications and NMAP switches are a big thing to remember. So something that's helped me is analyzing how those scans work at the packet level. So I thought I would start out with the Stealth Scan and show you how that's different than the full TCP Connect scan. Hopefully this helps you get a better understanding of those NMAP commands and how they will be useful when you're enumerating networks. So get out NMAP and Wireshark and let's go ahead and get to it. All right, so first let's break down how an NMAP Stealth Scan works. So here in my Kali Linux box, I've got a terminal on the left and that's where I have NMAP. And on the right, I've got my Wireshark there and I'm gonna go ahead and capture what these scans look like, take a deeper look at what is actually going on in the wire. All right, so let's go ahead and first generate just a simple stealth scan. Now, some scans in NMAP do require admin privileges. So I'm just gonna do sudo NMAP and that's where I got my scan type is stealth. That's how I remember it. It's like scan stealth, SS. All right, and then I'm gonna just throw in my target and let's go ahead and let this fly. All right, so this target has a lot of different ports open in on it. So what I'm gonna do is to actually capture this, go ahead and do this again. I'm gonna capture this, but this time I'm just gonna add a port value. All right, so let's just say port 80, cause that's open. Okay, I'm gonna come over here to Wireshark. Let's go ahead and start this guy up and I'm going to go ahead and run that scan. All right, so just gonna go over here and stop. So to take a look at what this scan looks like in Wireshark, just to blow this up a little bit for you. Now, again, this was our stealth scan. So, all right, our ARPS went ahead and went over. So I go ahead and send out that SYN and this port is open and available on that server. So it responds with a SYNACK and come over here and that just took about a millisecond or so. And then after that, what I would normally expect to see is I would expect to see the last packet of the three-way handshake, the final ACK, SYN, SYNACK, ACK. Now here, instead of seeing that, I actually see a reset from the device that's doing the NMAP scan. Now, why would it do that? You see, if I send acknowledgement, what that means is I'm telling the other link partner, okay, let's go ahead and establish state. Let's go from our TCP listening state to an actually open state where we can begin to use data on this connection. But in this case, I don't want to do that. Basically, what I'm doing is I'm knocking on the door, I'm waiting to hear a response, and then I run away. Thank you. Now I know you're open. I'm out of here. Don't worry about officially and formally connecting with me. So what this does is it makes it to where that server is not bothered with establishing a true connection because it never gets an ACK from me. And on my end, I never actually fully initiate the TCP connection because I'm sending a reset. I'm done with it. So that's why it's called a stealth scan. It's like we're knocking on the door and then we're getting out. Okay, so hopefully that helps you remember how that stealth scan looks on the wire. Now, one other thing that I'd like to mention about the stealth scan is that this is NMAP generated itself and it requires raw packet privileges of the system. But let me show you why I say that. If you take a look at the SYN, just something I want you to notice about the difference between this scan and the one that we're about to go into, the full connect. If you come here, now notice down in the TCP header, if you take a look, I'm just going to collapse IP, come down to TCP. And if you take a look at the TCP options, notice here that the only option that I have in this TCP SYN is this MSS value of 1460. And also my window size is only 1024. Now, if you've seen any of my videos or if you've done any TCP analysis yourself, this is actually pretty weird these days. Usually you see a SAC option, you might even see a timestamp, or you'll see a window scale factor in the handshake. So right here, this SYN is basically NMAP generated. This is not intended to be a full connection that an application would use. This was just a quick test run by NMAP just to see if that port is available on TCP. So let's go ahead and contrast that by what we see with the full connect scan. So let's go ahead and come over here to our command and we're just going to just hit up arrow. And instead of SS, I'm going to type in, and what is it, everybody? What's the full connect scan switch? Well, instead of SS, it's dash small s and then T. All right, so ST, and I'm gonna leave that port value of 80 and then that same target. So let's come over here, let's go ahead and capture this. But I'd like you to remember what we see here. We only see that MSS. Okay, so let's go ahead and start our capture again. Continue without saving. Let's come in here and just gonna run that full scan. Okay, can I come over here and I'm going to stop it. So first of all, if we take a look at the first SYN there, now notice that this is a little bit different than what we saw before. First of all, our window size is actually a useful TCP window, not 1024 bytes, which is so small we can hardly use it from the stealth scan. This full SYN scan is actually run by the operating system stack itself. So NMAP actually passes the connect command to the operating system stack. It says, hey, we want to actually initiate a full TCP connection here. Not just a little ping, if you will, but we want to actually initiate a connection that could be used if we wanted to. So that's why we see here, we see a full or a window that's actually useful. And if I come down here, check out my TCP options. I've got 1460, I've got SAC permitted, timestamps, window scale, all that stuff is useful things that we're typically gonna see in a TCP handshake. If we take a look at our SYN ACK, we see the same, here we see the different options, that final ACK, and now we have a true TCP connection that was established between the actual operating systems that were involved. So that's an absolute full connect scan. So we can see that that's pretty different, isn't it? Now, since NMAP doesn't actually want to use that connection to send any data, that's why we see that reset after this. That reset goes off and we say, hey, never mind, I just established this handshake, but let's go ahead and shut this down and move on with our lives. Now, you might be thinking, why don't we just do this TCP full connect every time? Well, remember that it's possible on the receiving device, it's possible that this connection attempt could be logged. It's possible that depending on the device, it might say, oh, there was a connection attempt and it'll log it. So that's why the stealth scan, if we don't want that log to happen, that's why we're gonna do that half open SYN-SYNACK reset thing, because it's less likely that that will be logged. Just something to consider when we're trying to decide between those two scans. Okay, so I hope this gave you a bit more practice and some better understanding about how those switches work in NMAP. We looked at the stealth scan and the TCP full connect scan, how they look in Wireshark, and why we might use one or the other. Thanks for sticking with me on this learning journey, and I'm definitely gonna be posting more videos about how NMAP works in the future. All of you take care, and I'll see you in another video.